care of your chinny chin chin, you made it. So we'll be looking at HA-2021-07.
All right, thank you, Madam Chairman. This is a rezoning request by David Deloach for 5.40 acres to rezone from single family R-15 to neighborhood commercial CN. Subject property is located along South Church Street. It is a large vacant lot. There is no official street address assigned yet to the property. As you see on the zoning map on the screen and in your packet, R-15 zoning surrounds this property on both sides. However, there is some N1 zoning across the street to the southwest. You see some other RP and CN zonings scattered a little bit along the South Church Street corridor. Character area is suburban area for this property. As you can see on this map, it's also a mixed pattern along this corridor. Aerial imagery, this goes back, I think, to 2007. You see it was once an agricultural field from many, many years ago. You see the rooftops of houses. As you look northward from the subject property, you do see some rooftops and parking lots from church and a funeral home and a few non-residential uses. It's quite a bit of a mixed pattern along there, but nothing too intensive until you get on to the south of the properties and off of the screens of this area. Applicant is proposing a mixed village of commercial and mainly probably office uses. Subject site plan is there in your packet. They're showing at least a concept form, five buildings, each of them about 5,600 square feet. Parking matches. This is exactly the minimum parking requirement for a commercial center in Hahira. It's actually slightly more restrictive, the number of parking than what is required in Valdosta. Front elevations, conceptually again, sort of a toned down, smaller version. The facades are showing what looks like two-story, and that I'm told is cosmetic only. Square footage that they are showing in their plans is for one-story buildings that matches the parking. The only thing that would inhibit going two-story for like an upstairs office or storage area is the number of parking spaces. Subject property, a fallow field, been there for many, many years. Adjacent properties to the southwest, this is probably the more intensive use of the warehouse building. A small commercial building straight across the street, up close to the road. And then some houses as you look along. These photographs really are here to emphasize a pattern along South Church. Of course, the properties on the east side of the road to the north and south are residential, similar to what you see here, except on some larger lots. We talked about this at length at the work session. Staff is recommending approval of RP zoning instead of CN. The last page in your packet shows a comparison of those two zoning districts. RP does allow some light commercial uses with special exceptions. It's a little different than what we see in Valdosta. So the staff's view there, you get a flavoring of some of the commercial uses. But CN is the low end of the food chain when it comes to commercial settings in Hahira. We see what some of those uses are there. We had talked about maybe a conditional CN zoning at the work session. I emailed you a copy of some of that language that we talked about. I've also spoken to the applicant about that as well. He may have some commentary suggestions for you when he gets up to speak. But other than that, I'll be glad to answer any questions you may have.
Yeah, Matt, I'm referring to the what's in the packet is the aerial location map. What is that strip of land behind the yellow parking? Does that belong to the applicant, or is that to be left as it is, or what?
All right, the aerial, you see a gap of land between what is denoted as subject property and Barfield. Mm-hmm. If you look at the site plan, that is a proposed row of six single-family lots developed under R-15 zone. So in other words, no zoning change for those lots. They could be developed and sold as R-15 lots. R-15 standards. We actually currently have a subdivision plat currently pending approval, depending on some details. So in essence, a row of single-family lots will separate this from the
are the locations of the pods and the parking areas on the site plan, is that fixed or is that just proposed? Can that be changed or altered?
It can be, but this is not, you're not approving a site plan, this is simply a zone change.
I'm just asking about the site plan.
The site plan, the numbers match. They showed 5,5600 square foot buildings. Each of those requires a minimum of 28 parking spaces if they were to stand individually. And interestingly, each little parking area in front of each of those buildings is 28 parking spaces. So it matches the minimum exactly. As you see on here, there is room for a little bit more in terms of both building and parking. This site has not been engineered yet, it's just preliminary. You can kind of see the topo lines as they uphill to the east. The part along South Church is the bottom of the hill. That is likely where the stormwater management areas will be. They have not been designed yet, so we don't know just how large of an area they will take up. I suspect more than one area. Even the length of some of these parking lots, they may want to loop them together a little differently just for better traffic flow, but lots of room to work with here. But yes, the site will hold more than what you're seeing here.
And last but not least, are there any restrictions RN versus CN, directional lighting protection for neighbors? Or
it's all the same.
It's all the same.
Right.
Thank you.
The only thing is the CN would be more as a commercial development throughout rather than RP, which would be office development. We touched on that at the work session. The only real difference it makes there is when we look above the yards.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you, Mark.
We'll go to
the line.
Commissioner Bailey.
Matt, I'm just curious. The facade presented us tonight is very attractive, and it does give the illusion being two-story. Do you have any heartburn for two-story?
Two-story will work as long as you can balance it out with the parking on the site. It starts to make it a little more commercial. I think if we went to the second floor, I personally prefer a Mansard-type roof with dormers, so it doesn't look quite so commercial. Maybe a difference between the front buildings versus the back buildings.
I get. I just have a method to my madness. I'm just curious if you had hard work with it.
It's all about the numbers, square footage, number of parking.
Yeah, all right. I did another quick question. Since we do have those R-15 lots in the rear, is there any kind of buffer required between this project and the?
Oh yeah, it'll be a commercial buffer between this and residential.
I just see the conditions. I'm just curious.
It's automatically required. If this gets rezoned to commercial, the commercial zoning and commercial development next to single family. That will be up in the 20-foot buffer yard.
Okay.
Matt, how does the applicant feel about the RP?
The applicant has, we talked about that in the beginning, they are requesting CN. They want just a little more range of possible use on the commercial side of things. One of the things I didn't mention, but it's in the packet, what they're proposing here is one common area development with each of these buildings pads to be leased or sold as individual units or building pads. So it would be a shared parking, covenants, restrictions, architectural controls. From my latest conversation with them, they're also going to limit some of the uses. Remember, at the work session, we looked at the list in CN. Some of those uses were a little more intensive than we were comfortable with. I think the applicant agrees with that. So, but I'll let him share those.
So, Commissioner Woods, what we talked about in the work session was that Matt's proposal kind of limits some of the uses where each tenant would have to individually come back to us if they did not fit in that box. And we felt like CN would prevent tenants from having to come back. So, and I'm sure we could probably extend the last one on the other team. Right. Were there any more questions down here for staff? All right, do we have any more questions before we open it up? All right, since there are no questions, is there anyone here tonight who wishes to speak on behalf of this request? If you will, please state your name and address.
Good evening. My name is Deloach, 2422 Bigfoot Drive. Matt said good job in the presentation. I'm glad to answer any more questions One thing, Frank, on the buffer between the residential and the commercial, we will have a 6-foot privacy fence between the two. Matt and I discussed seeing with restrictions. Don't have any problems with restrictions other than sort of being 3,000 square feet. What we would like to do is limit it to one building. Just feel like 3,000 square foot for a doctor's office or a dental office is probably enough adequate space. So other than that, if anybody has any questions.
Okay. Anybody have questions? Really? I'm so shocked.
I just want to comment on leading Matt down the trail.
And you refused to go.
The facade and the different textures and everything is very attractive.
What we tried to do, Frank?
That's not my question. Okay. My question is, since we give the appearance of a multi-high, has there been any consideration to doing a two-story with a residential application above?
We just wanted to design it like old Hahira used to be. We've got some pictures and kind of had it done. So that we haven't completed the one that we just pairing all of
them. Well, I commend you because I can tell you have been involved in trying to bring businesses to Hahira. We have one, no inventory for people. There's just nowhere for people to go. So, and two, we had very little buildable. So I'm excited to see this opportunity opening up.
Yeah.
All right.
You have a timeline
there?
Excited to see it. Thank you. All right, is there anyone else here tonight who wishes to speak on behalf of this request? All right, is there anyone here tonight who wishes to speak against this request? Please come forward. Anyone wishing to speak against? All right, that being said, I'll close the public hearing portion, turn it back over to the commissioners. Any other discussion? Okay. If no discussion, I will call for a motion. And keeping in mind the email that we received from Matt regarding the conditions, if we chose to go the CN route.
Matt, could you repeat those? I'm just curious for the audience.
Sure. This would be upon conditional CN zoning consistent with the conference plan and the standards for the exercise of zoning power. I recommend approval of conditional CN zoning instead to the City Council subject to the following two conditions. Number one, development of this property shall be in the form of a multi-tenant office or commercial development consisting of more than one building with no individual business tenant space exceeding 3,000 square feet gross floor area. Number two, the following uses shall be excluded and prohibited on this property: travel trailer park and self-storage facility. And those are both permitted uses in CN zoning otherwise.
Okay. Okay.
Deloach had mentioned that in order to service some people's needs, that we may need to just dedicate one entire building to that individual or that business. And that would be, as you mentioned, around 5,600 square feet. So is there any reason that, that you might have a problem with increasing the 3,000 foot that you mentioned to 5,600?
Yeah, as I shared with you in the work session, if you look at the CN column, some of those uses that are allowed in CN but not RP, one is a restaurant. A 5,600 square foot restaurant is very commercial and can generate an awful lot of traffic, limiting the size, you know, would help with that. Retail stores, unfettered, could be 5,600 square feet, depending on the type of store, grocery store, that sort of thing. I know he's wanting not a huge restaurant like an Olive Garden. An Olive Garden, like an Olive House, is 7,500 square feet, which is not that much larger. 5,600 is still pretty good size. But a small little cafe, like up the street from here, Church Street Coffee, is nowhere near 5,600 square feet. Like it's not even near 3,000. But it can fit as a small little cafe as part of the village. I think that works a lot better. I'm just concerned about the potential of this acreage is for one large store, and we've had inquiries about that.
My concern, though, is a doctor's office, once it's divided up with exam rooms, could easily eat up 3,000 square feet quickly. So that would limit a physician or an attorney, you know, with a huge staff to come in, so.
And the large doctor's office, similar problem, but it's allowed in RP. One of the things the applicant and I talked about, and this is, again, just conceptual, 5,600 square feet, you see five tenant spaces on this facade. In their preliminary analysis of it, those were 1,100 square foot each, approximately. His concern from 3,000, 3,300 worked better in the math, would allow three of these prototypes to be combined together as one unit. Whereas 3,000 wouldn't allow him to do that, he'd have to change the facade in order to do that. And my understanding is they're going to build sort of the shell building with a nice looking facade to go with it, and I would be amenable to accommodating that because this type of architecture makes it look more like the village.
Okay.
So what's the answer to that?
Yeah, I didn't get the answer.
Not the David. What's the answer?
The answer is just make your motion, and if you choose to use Matt's guidelines of 3,000 square feet, just know that that would mean some adjustments for the builder because each unit is approximately 1,100 square feet, or you could make your own recommendation in your motion for a square footage maximum.
But your question to me is 5,600 too big for one unit? The short answer is yes.
Yes. Okay.
Madam Chair, I'm going to make a motion, and I'm going to borrow from staff's wording in the email he sent us earlier today with a couple of changes.
Okay.
So I'm basically reading this to a certain extent.
Okay.
We find conditional CN zoning consistent with the comprehensive plan and the standards of excellence of zoning power. And therefore, we recommend approval of conditional CN zoning instead of RP to the City Council of Hahira with two conditions. Number one, development of this property shall be in the form of a multi-tenant office or commercial development consisting of more than one building with no individual businesses, tenant spaces exceeding 5,600 square feet gross floor area. And number two, the following uses shall be excluded and prohibited on this property: travel trailer park and self-storage facility. That's my motion to the city.
All right, we have a motion. He said 5,600. Okay, so we have a motion to approve with two conditions: to limit gross floor area to 5,600 and travel trailer parking and storage facilities prohibited. Do I have a second?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, second by Commissioner Lady. All right.
Can I direct the question to Dave?
Certainly.
Dave, I'm just curious, wanting the 5,600 as a physician's office or something like that, do you have anybody that y'all are talking to about that?
Not specifically, no.
Okay. All right, so we have a motion to approve with two conditions, and it is seconded. Is there any discussion? All right, all those in favor of the motion to approve, please raise your right hand. And all those against, and that motion carries. Thank you, Matt.